Hi, everyone. It's Blessing EP coming in from Melbourne, Australia. And have we got an exclusive for you? That's right. And how are you today, Sabine? Coming in from the UK?
Yeah, from Twickers. I'm fabulous. I'm wearing my Warhol shirt because I'm very arty as well.
I want to introduce the world to Jeff Cummings. Now, this man, to me, is one of the greatest artists for covers and records because doesn't it blow your mind when the man's done the cover for Wings Over America? To me, that says it all there. How are you today, Jeff? Now, can you show me the artwork to the Wings album and tell me how you got the job on that one? Because that's the biggest one out there.
Sure thing. Okay. Front cover, that was a photograph retouched, and I did the gatefold sleeve for the inside.
Now, I was saying, I got a songbook with that art cover. I reckon it must be Wings Over America, that songbook. That's what I think it is.
Yeah,
all right. And I have this one.
That's it. Say with Michael Jackson. Steve. What another cover. Tell me how you got that Say cover.
I just got a call. I basically got a call. I went in to see Paul, and he explained how he wanted the cover doing. And he had this kind of punching in the air thing, and I didn't quite understand what he was on about, so he grabbed my hand, you know, and said, you know, like this. I actually said to him, can we get some pictures of me and you doing that? And he said, no, you just go get on with it, you know. And when he went out of the room, I said to Linda, is there any chance you can get some pictures of Paul just doing that?
Yeah.
And like, I don't know, about a week later, I got some Polaroids from Linda. She'd obviously cornered him and said, come on, get on with it.
Fabulous.
So, I love that. Now, I've got to say, I mean, you meet Paul. How many times have you met Paul in private meetings?
It didn't really count. I remember when I first met him, he walked in the room and I thought, he looks very familiar. He's just like, bizarre, you know. So, but... once I met him, whenever a job came up, I got a call and I went in and he briefed me, you know, so I met quite a lot. We used to get invited to the do's and stuff as well, you know, if Linda was having an exhibition or Paul was doing his Buddy Holly thing, you know, and it was great, you know. I used to hang out with this guy, Alan Crowder, who worked for Paul, and at any of the do's, I'd be standing with him. Everyone knew Alan and came up and said, hi, Alan. And Alan would go, this is Jeff. He did Wings Over America. And that would be my introduction to him. You know,
fantastic.
Stars.
Sirius McCartney fans, they're all into Thrillington. And I know the guy that drummed on it, he doesn't come to my head at the moment. But can you show us the album Thrillington? Tell us about that story.
Yeah, sure. Okay. I just have to have one here, the original cover.
Yeah.
I think they're quite rare these days. They reissued it, didn't they?
Yeah.
And I did the back as well. And it was like my first cover, really. I did a few little bits and pieces here and there. When I started my freelance career, I looked for Paul in the Yellow Pages and I found his company because I knew what the company was called. And I called them and I said, can I speak to Paul McCartney's manager? And they put me through. I mean, and I spoke to a guy called Brian Brolly, who was managing Paul back then. And he was a lovely guy, you know. And I just said to him, I'm an artist and I'm keen to do record covers. Can I come in with a portfolio? And he said, yeah. And I went in, I met him, showed him some of my probably crap work. he said, we've got this little project and we're not quite sure what to do with it at this point. And then he explained about Thrillington and you know, the character and everything.
Yeah.
And I just went away and scribbled, you know. And they liked what I did, so next thing
I got the job.
Can you show me the cover of the Wings Over America, please, one more time?
Yeah, sure. Sorry.
Great. Show me the front cover. I just want to say, I bought that. When it first came out, that's the side of the aeroplane flying or on the ground.
Yeah, that's it. That's the kind of concept. They photographed the side of a fuselage and then... It was retouched by Richard Manning, I think.
Yeah.
Probably. Yeah, but it was a nice cover. And I think it was art directed by Hypnosis, you know, in London. They
yeah,
all kinds of albums for everybody, you know. Through Thrillington, because they art directed that, they put the cover together. That was my introduction to them. I already knew them. I was a fan of theirs when I was in art school. So I met Poe and Storm and Pete around that time. And they asked me to draw up concepts for them. They couldn't draw. They were very good photographers, very great, great creative thinkers, you know. And I wish I'd kept copies of all these things, because some of my dreadful scribbles became like classic albums.
Your initial sketches and stuff, have you not kept them in a folio?
At the time, you never thought about longevity.
No. Where did you go to art school? Where did you go? Which college?
I actually just went to a local one in North Wales. So it was...
Wales. Your accent is not from North Wales.
Well, my part of North Wales is just separated by a river and then another river, which is the River Mersey. So
there you go. It's the Liverpool twang that I'm picking up.
There's a bit of London as well chucked in as well, you know.
I love it. I love accents and dialects.
When I first met Paul, I turned up the Scouse end of my accent. And he went, I recognise that. And I said, no, I'm from North Wales. And he said, where about? And he knew the town, you know, because they used to play around area where I lived, you know.
Jeff, I want to ask you, you did the cover for Private Secretary. Have you got those covers there, Private Secretary? Yeah. And what's the other one you did?
Yeah, how it came about, I got a call again from Paul's office, and I was briefed by Roger Huggett, who was an art director, worked very closely with Paul. And he just explained, you know, what it was called. And I came up with this fairly... I was kind of into Norman Rockwell, the American artist. Someone got me into that, weirdly. And I sort of went away from the kind of dynamic stuff to this more humanized kind of way of working, you know. And it's a bit of a cliche. It's probably not very PC these days, but it was basically, you know, secretary sitting on Paul's knee. And my wife posed for the secretary. She was about 6 months pregnant at the time. And I just did the sketch. And I didn't hear anything for about a week. So I phoned Roger and I just said, look, you know, if I'm going to paint this, I need some time. And he says, no, it's done. It's sorted. I said, oh, thinking they'd use something else.
Yeah.
And he said, no, we've used the drawing. And I went, oh, wow. So when I saw it, he kind of explained that he was colouring up my drawings on prints and adding a bit of colour to present to Paul. If I knew they wanted colour, I would have done it myself. But because I do it on sort of bromide paper, like photographic paper, the ink repelled. And when Paul saw them, he quite liked the look of the ink, apparently.
So
he asked Roger for some blanks and Paul did all the colourisation on it. And I think the glasses on the secretary as well.
Paul's a bit of an artist. I've got his books.
Yeah.
It's like a coffee table book. It's huge.
I've seen some fantastic work, you know. And some crazy little sketches like John
and
Lennon.
John Lennon could draw, you know, as well. You know, it's amazing how talented, not just in music, but artistically, as in, you know, drawing, sketching, painting.
I mean, it sounds like he art directed most of the people's stuff, you know, and he always has his hand in that. And, and you know, he was very proactive on design always when, you know, from my experience, even with Hypnosis. I mean, I think maybe he frustrated one of the members of Hypnosis because he was like, well, he doesn't follow our ideas. We're just doing his ideas, you know. and then the other one said, yeah, but it's Paul McCartney, all right?
Yeah, so, exactly.
Why not?
Yeah.
But he is. I mean, it's not like he produces rubbish. He's an amazing guy, you know.
Yeah.
It's just unbelievable. It's staggering, really. I mean, I used to sit there, stand there, talking to him and kind of, you know, just as a person. But
how did you find Paul, actually? Was he very sort of, you know, very sort of down to earth, you know, kind of normal like that, just very sort of easy going to talk to?
He was very that, but you were also aware that you know, he could work on many levels, you know.
Yeah.
And I remember one time, it's just that bizarre thing about the person and being a fan of the star.
Yes, yeah.
And I was up to do Rock Show, the poster, initially, for the Wings of America tour. Mm. They set up a video in his office, and I was due to go just watch it and then get some inspiration from it and everything. Mm. And Paul was working up in the same floor in a mezzanine suite, sort of a bit, and he had a little pump organ up there, and he was up there with George Martin and another guy, and they were playing this little tune, and I was just like, before I went in, don't disturb them, let them finish.
Yeah.
So they came down. Paul introduced me to George Martin and this other guy, Oscar Grillo, his name was. I put the video on and I'm getting into rock, you know, the gig. Mm. And then Paul came back with this storyboard, and he explained what they were doing. And it was the bear thing, you know, the frog song.
Yes, so yeah. Have that too, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But he was trying to engage with me. He had this thing, and I'm sitting there watching him on the telly. And he's kind of showing it me, and I'm kind of going, good. Yeah. No. And it was like,
yes,
I watched Paul McCartney on the telly, you know. And I didn't think about it until I went home. I was on the train going home, and I'm thinking,
yeah.
What did he just do?
What just happened? I love it.
Tell me about the Paul McCartney cover, this one.
It's a strange story, this one. I got a call from another art director that worked with Paul. And he said, do you want to do a single cover for Paul? I went, yeah, of course, yeah. But I wondered why he was calling me. Then he explained that Paul was doing this kind of Asian thing based on sort of Indian culture. And he was looking for an authentic Asian artist, I suppose, to do the painting based on the old stuff, you know. And the guy that contacted me, he basically said, that's going to be too difficult for me to sort out, but you could do it in the style, couldn't you? And I said, yeah, of course I could. Yeah, I'll give it a go, for sure. But you've got to tell Paul it's me. You know, don't put the wall over the eyes or anything. Yeah. He said, yeah, no. I'll get him to approve the design. And then I'll let him know. Once he's bought into it, I'll let him know. So that was my terms and conditions, right? And it was Paul's idea. It was basically Paul's idea, based on the lyrics. And I went to an Asian bookshop and I found some of the old traditional stuff. And I put the design together, like a colour visual this time, pencil and stuff. And it was approved. And I went to art, but there wasn't enough time to paint it. I just had a weekend, so I did another kind of, a tidy visual, if you like. Mm. But long story short, basically, the art director didn't tell Paul it was me. He lost, he lost the bottle, as he said. And I'd already left a little clue on there, because I signed it with a kind of Snee Moon Fege, I think it was something, a little handwritten signature on the artwork. Mm. And but it was a kind of clue to Paul, really. And I know, once you knew, I was going to say, yeah, well, look, I gave you a clue there. And if you read it backwards, phonetically, it's Jeff Cummings.
Cummings, yeah, so exactly. Clever, I like that.
It went into production and everything, and I was really annoyed when this guy didn't, I'm not mentioning his name, I don't want to mention his name.
No, no.
When he didn't, you know, when he said he didn't tell Paul, because I thought this isn't going to work well for me. And anyway, Alan Crowder, who I mentioned earlier, I'd met him for a coffee, and he was telling me all about Flowers in the Dirt and the new single, this one. And I'm going, I already know, you know. And I felt like some kind of traitor, really. And then he invited me to a warm-up gig with the band going on tour with the stuff. And I went along, took a couple of my kids. There was a big point of sale thing in the area where you go into the theatre, of this one. And I'm going, oh my God. But I thought, I'm going to tell Alan. I have to tell him. I can't not tell him I did the artwork. It's weird. And I had this, which was the
cassette,
the audio thing, right?
Yeah, cassette tape.
It's got illustration by Snemu Fej, however you want to pronounce it, on the back. And I put it in my shirt pocket. And after the game, it was a great, great gig. It was really laid back kind of gig. And Paul did a version of Summertime, you know, and did a really nice
blow
and stuff. And I thought, wow, I've never even done that before. And anyway, I saw Alan. He was with a friend who I didn't know. I had my kids, introduced my kids. And I said, Alan, look, I've got this. I'm just looking at this thing. There's something weird about the name of the artist. And he goes, what are you on about? What? And his friend, who I hadn't met, looked over his shoulder and went, Jeff Cummings. And Alan just looked at me. He said, what the? And I said, I'll call you tomorrow. So the following day, I rang him and I just told him all about it, you know.
Yeah.
And I guess he did tell Paul. He never confirmed it totally, but the phone did go very quiet after that, you know. And it was it was a shame. I still ended up doing some work with the family. I did a portrait of Linda for Linda McCartney Foods and stuff, you know.
Oh,
and
that was
an absolute privilege, you know.
What for her food range? You mean for the?
Yeah, they always used photographs, but after she died, they wanted to use like a painting for a while, you know.
That's right. I've got that. Yeah, I've got everything. Yeah.
And Jeff, I want to tell everybody out there to go and buy your fantastic new book, right? The Invisible Artist.
I was approached by an independent publisher in Wales, in South Wales, and they normally do Doctor Who books. And I'm, apart from this stuff, I'm quite well known for doing Doctor Who as well. And I just said, I haven't got enough room for Doctor Who, but if you want to do like a retrospective of everything, I'm up for it, you know. So we ended up, can I show it here?
Yeah, go for it. Show everything.
The Invisible Artist by me. And it didn't take that long to write because it's just anecdotal, really. Mm-hmm. I've just talked about, I did Bruce Lee. Look at this.
Oh, wow.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. Just a few pictures.
I started off doing Bruce Lee, lots of Doctor Who.
I'm a big Doctor Who fan, me. Yeah.
You know, all this stuff.
Oh.
And then I work with a band called Silver Sun. I'm doing a book about them at the moment.
How did the title of the book come to you? Did it come to you quickly?
I think it's because a lot of my work has been seen, but people never know. See, I've got all Paul's stuff in here.
Oh, yeah, there we are, yeah.
I did a press ad as well. I did lots of other things, you know, bits and bobs on the side. I kind of based it around the idea, and often with illustrators as well, because it's kind of usable art. It's not like in a gallery. Mm. People don't really think about it as art or they think about or know who the artists are, you know?
So artists unknown, you know.
It's kind of based on that, you know, the artist is invisible, so this is
excellent. Yeah.
Tell everybody the links to where they can buy the book.
Okay, the company are called Candy Jar Books. If I can just click on here, no, I can't do that. I'll give you. I think if you Google Candy Jar Books, you'll find me. And and then you can order them directly. I got a copy of the lyrics books.
Oh, yeah.
Paul's company.
Fantastic. And
I found that in it.
Oh, look.
What do you hold?
I've got it too because I went to see him at the Festival Hall for his evening with Macca.
Did he sign that for you, Jeff?
Say again, sorry.
Did he sign that book for you?
No, I haven't seen him for ages. And I tried to get to that gig where he was talking about. So what I did get signed is this, which I treasure.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, it's huge. Wow.
Can you see this?
Look at that. Oh, that is absolutely fantastic.
That is magnificent, Jeff.
Yeah. Where does that hang in your house, Jeff?
I'm not telling, I hide it.
Oh, no, okay, don't worry.
It just starts to fade a little bit, so I put it away, basically.
Yeah, no, that is really special. That's really special.
I mentioned it just trying to find it. In short, I had to lift a load of stuff up and pull it out.
Oh, okay, that's why you're out of breath.
I just want to say, we love you. This is fantastic. Mm.